हेलो फ्रेंड्स, सो टुडे वी डिस्कस द प्रॉब्लम सी फ्रॉम द लेटेस्ट एजुकेशनल कोड फोर्सेस अराउंड 102, प्रॉब्लम नेम नो मोर इन्वर्जन्स। सो नाउ एज यू कैन सी इन दिस प्रॉब्लम सीम्स लिटिल बिट डिफिकल्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड फर्स्ट रीडिंग द प्रॉब्लम स्टेटमेंट, बट इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड द प्रॉब्लम स्टेटमेंट एंड द मोस्ट स्ट्राइकिंग थिंग ऑफ दिस प्रॉब्लम इज आई गॉट दिस प्रॉब्लम फ्रॉम द एग्जाम्पल्स। सो आई जस्ट लुक ऑन द एग्जाम्पल्स मोर केयरफुली हाउ द आंसर इज कमिंग आउट एंड इट जस्ट स्ट्राइक मी आउट at some glance and then I code it out and it comes out to be true. But I will be also telling you why the observation which I was doing was true. So as you can see, the problem statement states that you are given n elements as a form of A. So you have a sequence of A which has n elements like this, and you have also given some k. So the elements in A are like this, such that it goes on increasing till k and then keep on decreasing till n. So it's like this. So as you can see, there are some elements which is like increasing. So if you have some elements in n, so it keep on increasing and then like it keep on decreasing. So it can be like 1, 2, 3, 4. So it can increasing to like 4 and then it can come down to 3. So it can come down to like 2, 1, but it cannot boil down to 0. So it can maximum like be a hill from 1 till 1. So it always start from 1, then it goes down to some k and then it keeps on decreasing till the total length, which is n. Okay, so that's the whole first part of this line. Now inversion is, the inversion in A, as you can see, is a pair of indices such that I is less than j and ai is greater than j. So this inversion topic is mostly seen in sorting. So it just means that if there is some element which is before some element and it is greater than value, then it is called counted as inversion. So as you can see, if there is some element in this which is greater and it is on the left side, as you can see, for this element the inverse, like you can take this element which is greater on the left side, for this element are the inversions. So the total inversion for this is like, for this element, this, and you have to count out how many inversions are there for this sequence. So now the problem statement states that you have to find out a permutation p of size k. So you have to find out a permutation p of size k, which means that the permutations, like the numbers in this k, like this sequence of permutation p, should be from 1 till k, and you have to find out some another sequence b from this permutation p, like k, such that b of I is equal to p of a of I. Now a of I you can just start putting out here. So the a of I, like I equal to 1 is the first element, I equal to the second element, and so on. So the first element of bi is the first element of p, the second element, third element, fourth element, and then from fourth, like from third element, second element, so on and so on. So now your goal is to find out such a permutation. So you have to find out a permutation p which is of size k, such that the total number of inversion in B, the sequence, doesn't exceed the total number of inversion in A, the inversion is this. So the sequence which is given to you, which is A, you have to find out that the number of inversions in B should be lesser than the number of inversion in, like, B should have lesser inversions than A, and also B is lexicographically maximum. And that's the whole problem, you have to find it out. Now, if you look at this example, I'll talk about the last examples and I'll talk you what the observation which I look upon. As you can see, you can easily find out the array A, because you can see that the array A of is length of 3 and it keep on increasing till value 2. So it's like 1, 2, and then keep on decreasing, which is like 1. So 1, 2, and then keep on decreasing 1. Same as you can see, this is of length 4, so it keep on increasing till 3. So 1, 2, 3, and then 2. Okay, so it will be like 2 and 1 if there is length 5, and so on. So now let's assume that for this A, this is the P permutation you have find it out. Let's assume you have this P permutation. Now, if you want to find out the B, which is equal to, you have to keep on taking this element from this P. So as you can see, the first value from P, which is 2, second value from P, which is 1, the first value from P, which is 2, and this is the B vector, like the B array. Same as you can find out from this P, the first element, the second element, the third element, and the second element, and so on. So now you can easily find out, if you have A and like P, you can easily find out B, but you're actually only having A. So now can you build the array A easily? Yes, because actually K is less, and you have this information that you can first increase till the value K and then decrease out. So you can easily fill out or form this array A in O of N, which is fine. Now, if you can easily find out this array A, what you can do next is you have to somehow find the this permutation P. Can you find out some similarity between A and, like, you can easily find out A. Can you find out some similarity between A and P? The last element is same. And because you know that P is of length K, okay? P is of length K. And now, obviously, it is a permutation, so all the elements should occur once. The last element is same, the second last element is same. Now, two cannot come here, so only one can come. So it is like you're moving from left to right, like from right to left, and just writing out the elements. And if the element occurs once more time, you have to just find out a permutation, so just don't count it out. As you can see, like here. For this, as you can see, this is 1 and 2. From this is 2, 1, 1. And this logic is perfectly fitting, and like I just quoted out and it turns out to be true. But why it's true, I'll tell you why. So what we actually, like what is our actual requirement is, we have, or just write down this permutation only, 1, 2, 3, 2. This is actually vector A. Okay. And then what you're actually having next is K, which is like 2. So you have to find out for this, which is like I've written on this 1, 2, 3, 2 for the last example, and K is equal to 3. So you have to find out like permutation, which is of length 3, such that you have to build another B vector or B array of size 4. So just mark out 4 blanks here, which is like fine. Now, what you can easily do in this problem is, you have to first find out this permutation P, and then find out value B. Now you want the values in B such that this should be the lexicographically maximum, but the inversion should be less. Okay. Now, how do you fill out these values? Like, as you can see, if there are some values here, then you just move like this. First, say the first element, second element, third element, like the first element, second element, third element, and then go back. So it's like bouncing, like 1, 2, 3, then going back 1, 2, like, and so on. So it's like you are filling out the B vector in such a way that you are taking the elements in P, bouncing, like taking the first element, second element, third element, and then going back. So if you want the B vector to be the maximum, what you actually want? You want that the first element, like, should be the smallest element, or should be occurring, like this first element should be such that it should be the smallest, but the inversion should be less. So how you can minimize inversion? By putting out the first element to be smallest, the next element should be greater and greater, and so on. So you can put out the first element to be smallest. And as you can see, if you put out the first element to be smallest, you can put the permutation 1 at the first point, the second at the second point, and 3 at the third point. If you put it like this, then as you can see, you have to fill it according to this condition. So the first element in B will be 1, 2, 3, and 2. Which is like fine. Now, if you just invert it out, it's like 1, 3, and 2 in the permutation P, then you'll fill it like this, 1, 3, 2, 3. I hope you get the point how we are finding out this permutation P. So permutation P is of length 3, and it can be either like this or this. Now, as you can see, if I take out this, the permutation will be this. If I take out this, the permutation will be this, like the vector B, which is like this. Now, what you can again observe in this, is, as you can see, if I just flip out this, it will turn out to be a new vector. But now this is lexicographically maximum. Like this is lexicographically maximum. Why this is turning out to be maximum? Because this number is occurring, occurred before it. If this 2 is occurring before, this number will be before. If 3 is occurring before, obviously this number will be before. So it will be like lexicographically maximum. And thus, as you can see, if my number turns out before, as you can see, this number is going back. This number is going back. We know that this number will be going back. So I want that this number is going back. So this number should come first. Okay. And thus, if like K is equal to this, if you can see like 1, 2, 3, 4, and then it turns out to be like 3 and 2. What you can easily do here is you just move from back to front. So your permutation will be like this, which is like if you take out the second element in the last, the third element, then the fourth element, and then the first element. This is P. Now you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which is like this. And this is the P value. If you take out this P value and starting filling out and making a B vector, what you can make out the B vector, I'll tell you. Let's form out a B vector. Now this is P for this. You will take out the first element, which is the first, which is 1. Take out the second element, which is 4. Take out the third element, which is 3. Fourth element, which is 2. The third element, which is 3. Second element, which is 4. So it ends on the fourth element, which is the maximum. So you want that, as you can see, even if you're going back, you're making it maximum possible. When you're going from the front, because you have flipped it out, it is also maximum. And because the inversions are less, because you're forming it from A only. So the inversion is also less. So as you can see, like this is one intuition which come to my mind. This is the simplest, like the logic which I thought, because if you draw 2-3 examples, you can easily make it out that this is the possible answer which you can get. And now if you understand the logic part, now to code it out, it is also simple. Take the input of n and k, and what you can do, you have to, because you have to just make out this a vector of size n. So from 1 till k, it is increasing. So 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, as you can see, it is increasing, which is like a of I is just 1, 2, 3 till k, and from k plus 1 till n, it is like decreasing. So I'm decreasing out. Then you have to find out some another vector, which is so you have to find out p. Okay, so I'm actually finding out p. So I just mentioned out is b, but it is actually we are finding out p. So I can mark it out as p here. So how we are finding out like p here? So we just make out because we want that my vector answer in the final is equal to p. Okay, so how we are finding out this value, as you can see, we go from back to front, and whatever number we have encountered first, store it out somewhere. But if you have encountered this number again, we don't take it again. We just, because you have to find out this p, okay? So in because we have formed out a, as you can see, this a is created. So now move from like right to left from in a, and whatever number you have encountered, store it out, like store it out. And if this number is again encountered, leave it out, because you have to find out a permutation p of like length k, which has a single occurrence of all of these numbers. So that's what you're doing. For finding out single occurrence, I make out a set or actually a vector, which is like this. This is actually a b vector, or you can say like any vector, which is just storing out that whether this number is occurring again or not. So that's what I'm doing. I'm moving from like the last element to the first element, and finding out that whether this element I have seen again or not. If I have seen again, then I have marked out one. So just continue on. If it not, we have not seen it again, just push this number in answer vector and marked it as one, which means that now I've taken this number in answer vector and pushed it out. So like just mark it out one, that I should not take it again. And then my all the numbers are in the reverse order, because I'm storing out 2, 3, 1. 2, 3, 1 is not the answer. 1, 2, 1, 3, 2 is the answer. So we have to again reverse it out. And after reversing out, this is the answer. I hope you understand the logic as well as the code. If you draw out some examples, it will become more clear. I'll see you in the next one. Till then, keep coding, and I'll see you in the next one.